towards bottom, and they are actually getting a rotation in from Noya, so they might want to go in on this one druid before Mag really gets himself some early farm. Are gonna smoke three down low. Ace Rise, Noya, they're making their way down low.
Dire's bottom tower is under
their way
attack.
Downtown.
Oh.
There's the Shikuchi, and Mag might be in a little bit of trouble. There's the Ignite coming in from Noya. Bear a little bit low. He might be in a little bit of trouble. Ace gonna come in again with the Shikuchi Rises right around the corner.
Jukes.
And Mag juking out pretty well. Sima is here. There's the disruption. They slow it down for just a moment. Ryze is pretty low. He's at about half health. Mag trying to do something, but there's the Shikuchi from Ace, and it will be another kill in the way of C9.
Yeah, it was actually perfect timing. Right as Mag used his phase boost, they disrupted him, so they were able to block him in the trees. If they hadn't done it right then, and he had phased through, so really nice timing from Ryze. I don't know if it was intentional or not, but if he hadn't done it just right then he may have lived if he had squeezed past the Weaver.
Mag. He's back, phase boots. He does get this root on Ace. Ace might be in a little bit of trouble. Wow! Okay.
First hit root.
Seema's just gonna come in, snipe that kill away from Mag. Say your RNG is not worth it. That kill right from you.
Yeah, it's definitely the kind of start you want to have in a launcher, not a hero that deals well at all with having a bad landing start. And they realize that this Weaver's not getting enough down here. Only the Fasty, the Wand, and the Boots already. Mag having the Phase Boots, 300 gold on top of it. So, gonna rotate Darkseer down here as well. Darkseer having a really poor time up top. So, Kana trying to switch things up. Maybe get a kill on Dindra.
Rise and Ace up top. There's the disruption coming through on Dindra on the Venge. They're gonna try and find themselves a kill. The Magic Missile does come out on Ace. He's gonna use the Shikuchi to move on forward. Seema is here just in case they want to try and turn it around on Ace. There's the Poison Touch as well. Seneko here. The Decay Rise is gonna get very low. He'll fall first. And this engagement up top between C9 and Vega, Seneko, Dijira, and Seema are all here, and Dijira does survive when it looked it was as though it was dead to rights, but rotations out from both the Dazzle and the Undying keeps him alive, and they do end up turning it around, as well as getting a kill on Hestajo down low as G, with the Dream Coil, finds another one on Hestajo. So Baby Knight, right here up with G, and they might be able to find themselves a kill. There's the Astro Imprisonment. Noya does have Fire Blast as well as Knight as and Bloodlust. They'll just use the Fire Blast, and Baby Knight will find a kill on G. So it's a one-for-one trade. They lose their Darkseer, but do get the return kill on G. Now 3-3, and that's a bit of gold going the way of C9. We'll switch it over to the net worth, take our first look at the graph, and it's 2,000 in favor of Vega in both the XP and the net worth.
Yeah, it was pretty unfortunate for G. Had got pathing a little bit, was trying to walk through the trees, and the OD was right there, so got blocked, tried to orb away, but right as the orb got astraled, so wasn't able to jaunt away, and gets run down and killed as with no orb to jaunt to, and your initial astral damage kills him off, so.
Noya's trying to go in on Mag with the Ignite, does bring Mag a little bit low, but he does have this shrine right next to him. Noya's still sticking very close. Noya wants to be in the vicinity now that this one druid is healed back up to full. Baby Knight made up against G, coming around is Seneca with the decay. There's the Astro Imprisonment out on G. Like that, that engagement will be over.
They do get a sentry up top for Ditcha, so able to keep him up here, still soloing and still top of the net worth charts, so giving him a little bit of a head start and then just sort of leading him in this top lane, continuing to do very, very well versus Weaver. And Shadow Demon looks like he can force Seneko off, maybe have a fight here.
And there's the disruption again, but Seneko, he's right there, ready to go with that decay.
Mag continuing to farm up, has that Aquila now, so Phase Aquila on the Lone Druid. Almost level 10, so gonna have that plus 200 attack range. So much attack range for a level 10 talent. Noya wraps around mid as well, so he uses his orb, they may be able to threaten a kill here and get Baby Knight sort of back into this game, although he's mostly caught up on the puck. If he get this kill, it'll be really nice for him as well.
Oh, I missed the kill on Joe down low. I was looking mid and thought maybe Noya would go in before something happened down low. We missed the kill on Hestajo. There's the Astro Imprisonment on G. G at about half health. Neko is here, does get the decay. There's the Dream Code. They do drop the Tombstone. Baby Knight gonna try and get rid of this Tombstone. There's the Waning Rift. And coming in with the Illusory Orb is G. And they will find that kill on Baby Knight.
Baron Aspiration from Zuniko. I mean, it pushed up pretty far in the lane, all the way up to G's Hill, so he gets the coil down. Kill the OD, and another nice kill, and then they're not really getting much off of it still.
Yurod just gonna try and TP out, just a little bit of health left, and will successfully do so. Ace and Ryze really harassing Yurod with that disruption, as well as the swarm.
Yep, so Vega getting some kills here and there. So trading kills back and forth. Not really any objectives going down, not many of the towers low in HP at all. Autumn Tower, probably the lowest for Radiance, but other than that, just a lot of back and forth kills. People casually farming in lanes as much as they can. Digira hasn't had enough of being left alone top, is gonna run down a bottom, maybe look for a kill and has to Joe and pressure the tower. Also Niku goes top to defend this because really wasn't getting much farm. Yep, they smoke up, gonna try and make a move happen. I really like this from Digira, getting his level four stun and gonna make something happen. So he's really one of the only heroes on his team that has the capability to make a play like this.
As to Joe, gonna try and surge his way to freedom right into the hands of Digira. There's the magic missile as well as the swap with the poison touch. Bear's gonna
first
get that
root.
First hit root again. I haven't seen this kind of lucky RNG. Faceless Void in the international with the bashes. No first hit root. You'll take it. We're not gonna take it. Digira, Seema, and Mag combined for a kill on Hesta Joe down low.
I think he was dead regardless, but Sir Salt in the Wound, the classic, dude, he root me.
Dire's structures are fortified.
As I do start hitting on this tower, having level 4 and Bear, as well as the this Rabbit, so getting the extra building damage, forcing Hesta Joe to TP back down here, as well as Noya. Whale on top a little bit, but Undying is here, defending this tower. GTP's in, so it looks like.
From G, he's gonna get that waning rip. Ryze is just gonna try and TP out. The decay comes in, as well as the illusory orb thrown by G. They will find a kill on Ryze, who was close to TPing out. Meanwhile, Noya will fall down low. There is a wall used. They've lost two on the side of Cloud9. It's now 8-3, and they are going to lose Seema to Baby Knight. The vacuum comes back in. Hesta Joe and Baby Knight are here. There's the surge out on Baby Knight. He's trying to move on forward, trying to find something, and Mag's going to just out of range of Baby Knight to get that Astral Imprisonment down.
Yep, another quick kill on Dazzle. Like I said before, just sort of trading kills back and forth. Both teams defending their towers very hard. As I say that, our Dire mid tower taking a fair amount of damage, and diving back here.
Digira's here with Sineko. There's a Master Missile with the Tombstone. He's gonna have to Astral Imprison himself. The weave comes out from Seema. They turn around just a little bit. They're looking towards Baby Knight. Sineko gets very low, but Digira will get the kill on Baby Knight as Baby Knight goes a little bit too far. Meanwhile, as to Joe, he's in a bit of trouble, and he'll fall to Mag.
A golden thread. Almost the Dragonlance now as well on Mag, so I have the super attack range very, very soon, and gonna be able to kite this OD quite easily, as the OD very farmed are so far in this game. Level 9, working on the 4 staff. Really close to the Hurricane fight yet, so Mag in a very, very commanding position. G almost the Blink Dagger as well, so Vegas team fight is about to come online.
And they are coming in with Baby Knight and Ryze. There's the disruption out on Digira. The weave does hit. There's the swap back, and Seema's gonna be in a little bit of trouble. Digira to TP out and doesn't, as Ryze gets credit for the kill. And now Seema, he's surrounded by the entire side of C9. He'll fall as well. And the rotations come out from Cloud9, and they get a couple of kills on the retreat of Vega. Maybe not something they wanted to give up, but it is Dazzle, which isn't too bad, but it's Digira who's gonna fall as well.
Yeah, so Baby Knight taking advantage of that time where Puck's low on mana, he's trying to finish up his Blink Dagger, he's spawning that, just forcing Mag back. So they are going to trade towers, Vega heading to mid immediately after to make sure they don't lose completely out on that trade, but definitely happy with that. Cloud9 is he's picking up the HOD now as well, so as the HP creep. Also gives a little bit of mana, so giving this Weaver basically infinite Shikuchi spam because this HOD creep gives us tankiness against a lot of the Pox nukes, Revenge stun. So overall, just a very, very good item this patch, as well as the HP aura for all of the early fights that are going to be happening in this game. Really wants to have whatever he can to bolster his team's early skirmishing and fighting ability.
They're gonna try and keep this Roche while Cloud9 are down here trying to take a tier 2. This is a solid move by Vega as they may be feeling a little bit of trouble in these team fights after the last engagement, but with the Aegis, they should feel a little bit more confident going into the next engagement or two.
Yeah. Vega do TP a couple of heroes down bottom. They want to look for a fight here as Geez and Invisrune is moving down as well with the blink. Boyant and Ryze both pretty clumped up and see if you can find a two-man coil, but team's kind of far away, so don't know if they'll have enough backup to take them down.
He's gonna walk right into Ryze, and Noya is just gonna use that dream coil as well as the illusory orb and the waning rift, and will have enough to bring Ryze to his demise. He gets himself a kill, maybe thought he wanted the dream coil on both Ryze and Noya, but just gonna settle for getting the kill on Ryze. And they will head towards mid. Ace is here up against Mag. They might want to fight a little bit. Mag gonna try and run away. Ace going in with the Shikuchi. Still moving on forward, but Digirai is here. They might want to turn this around if you're the side of Vega. There's the Centaur. Stop, Ace in a bit of trouble. He'll go down to Digirai. So getting a little bit too aggressive there is Ace on this Weaver, thinking that maybe he can find himself a kill on Mag, but coming around the bend is Ditya-Ra, does get that Centaur stomp on Ace, as well as Magic Missile and the kill, which is very beneficial for the side of Vega.
Yep, very, very nice play from Ditya-Ra. A little bit fortunate as well, getting that Centaur creep, but walks it over, gets the perfect timing on the stomp, gets him just in time before you get that time lets off.
Ooh, there's the swap into the Centaur stomp, there's the decay. Esperjo might be in a little bit of trouble. He's gonna get hit by that magic missile as well as the wave of terror. He's gonna call to Digirra. Digirra, though, is gonna get his Aegis pop. They're turning around on C9. Ace is coming in. He's gonna get that weave out, and now feared up his Ace. Ace might be in a little bit of trouble. There's the time lapse as well. The magic missile, he's gonna get rooted up as well. Here comes the Sanity's Eclipse from Baby Knight, but not really doing too much. Baby Knight might be in a little bit of trouble. He's pushing himself a little bit too far forward. Digirra getting very low. There's the sword coming in from Sineko, not gonna be enough to save the life of Digirra, and hitting away at Mag is Baby Knight. G's got himself a kill. There's the Dream Coil coming out on Baby Knight. There's three devil already on the side of C9, and rooted up again is Baby Knight as he falls to Sineko, and three will fall on Cloud9, and they will only lose Digirra twice.
Yeah, as we can see, Vega playing around this range from Lone Druid super well. Almost has a death zone now as well, so not going for the typical Maelstrom, but going for more of that heavy, heavy right click. Combined with the Venge and the Minus Armor from the Dazzle, it's going to be a ton of damage. It's going to be shredding through some of these low armor heroes like Odie and Weaver, as well as Shadow Demon. So a little bit of a nuanced build there, but yeah, with the Dazzle and the Undying, a lot of heroes with some serious AoE, a lot of a protecting ability, keeping the Soul Druid alive and keeping him in the fight, constantly right-clicking and just murdering these heroes. The OD's armor super low there and just gets 4 or 5 shot by the Soul Druid, only with a Dragonlance at the time. So Ag playing very, very well this game, 5-1-6, and almost with the death zone online. 800 gold away as Ryze getting shredded at top.
Yeah, how can you say shredded? He's getting ripped apart by Mag in an easy solo kill for him. Teemo was there, but you know, Mag didn't really need too much help. Gets an easy kill on Ryze, should be a nice tier 1. Meanwhile, down at the shrine, Hester Joe trying to go in on G. There's the Bloodlust to try and speed up Noya so he can get the Fire Blast in on G. He's gonna get hit by this Satyr. And now G might be in a little bit of trouble. He doesn't get that phase shift with the Waning Rift, but the Illusory Orb not far enough away in time. And Ace and Noya will get the kill on G.
A little bit of a mistake there. Maybe he could have thrown the orb out and then phase shift afterward. Maybe he wouldn't have been able to live. Would have been close, so maybe delayed things a little bit, but probably still would have gone down. So nice retreat from Cloud9, getting that kill there. They're gonna get the tier 2 tower off it, but they do lose their top tier 2 tower. Mag does have the death zone now, so totally annihilates buildings. So much building damage between the bare extra building damage as well as the death zone, so.
Vega,
we said they needed to have a good early game, and they have had that so far, doing very well right now. It's the most of their cores sitting above most of the cores of Cloud9. Baby Knight, sort of the converse of the past few games, sort of the shining hope for Cloud9 right now with the Hurricane Pike as well as the Blink Dagger already, so pretty good spot on the OD.
We take a look over at Mag, he's got that Desolator and Dragonlance, and Kung Fu Panda. No?
Oops.
Doing okay. All he's got is his root, make himself worthwhile. You do see the smoke coming in from Vega. They're looking for a possible kill. Baby Knight walking right into their hands. There's the swap as well as the fear. There's an epic missile coming around with a wave of terror, and Dikura with another one. They're trying to grab this courier, but he gets hasted up and he'll run away. And it's another kill for Vega. They're up 18-8. Baby Knight, he's having an alright game. He really needs to find himself out of those positions. Meanwhile, G, he's going to use that Dream Coil out on Noya. Noya's going to run out of it, get stunned up. He's going to fall to Sineko. We find another one for Vega. Vega as five are going to push down mid, look for this tier two, and continue on forward, extending their lead just about 5,000 net worth.
Yeah, it was a really nice board that gave him the vision for that swap, so getting that deep board a little bit earlier in the game lets him spot the OD in. Cloud9, Baby Knight definitely knows he's swapping the low ground, and that does not happen unless you have vision, so probably gonna get that ward dewarded as soon as they
Rip
spawn
comes
are able
out
to
on
up.
Ace. Gonna be able to get out with the Shikuchi. Swap in on Ryze, and you're melted. Seema gonna get credit for that kill on Ryze. Dikura just going in with that swap. Doesn't need to use that magic missile, and now has it saved. Astro Imprisonment out on Dikura. They're still hitting away at the tier 3 tower mid. And C9, they're back on their heels. There's the Ignite as well as the Magic Missile. It's going to come out on Ace. He's in a little bit of trouble. He's going to use that time off. He's going to try and find himself away. He's going to get feared up with the two-stone. Down there is the Vacuum Wall on a lot of heroes on the side of Vega. But still not nearly enough follow-up from the side of Cloud9. They do get the Sanity's Eclipse off, but still nobody dead on the side of Vega. As I get tongue-tied as everything gets dropped from the side of C9 as well as Vega. So coming in is Baby Knight. They're looking to kill this bear. Bear will fall, and Mag does have another bear, but he doesn't exactly need it.
Oh, nice dodge. Did dodge the Ignite with the Lunge Roll team.
And Sineko in a little bit of trouble. He's going to get shell graved up by Seaman. The bear's going to come in, and I'm not too sure C9 really want to chase as everybody's still alive on the side of Vega Squadron. And a little bit of a taunt there. I'm pretty sure that's auto when you get out with that little health.
Yeah, they just barely get out there. Lundry getting his level 15, so getting the plus 65 damage as well. Pushing out 257 a pop, and has the Hurricane Pike now as well. So Mag getting very, very strong. And yeah, the OD used this fight, Zolti. Weren't able to really able to finish anyone off. He's just not enough farm to really like go into these heroes. The Tombstone was up for a really long time. The fight had a huge impact. Has a casual buckler on the Undying.
Kind of come in on Mag. There's the disruption. They do have Baby Knight on the back end. Mag might be in a little bit of trouble. There's the Soul Catcher. The Demonic Purge trying to find something, and there is the weed. Hit on Baby Knight and Hested Joe. Dream Coil comes out on Baby Knight. Knight might be in a little bit of trouble. He's stunned up. There's the Waning Rift coming in from G. They're still trying to run him down. Baby Knight gonna use that Astro Imprisonment, trying to save himself enough time to get that Hurricane Pike off cooldown as well as the Blink. It does get the Blink down to the low ground. Still trying to come in with that Illusory Orb. Baby Knight trying to TP out. Ooh. And Will with just 200 health. Ooh, so close. Baby Knight up against four of the heroes on the side of Vega just barely escapes with his life.
Yeah, that was very, very fortunate. May have lost Rax there if he went down, but just barely escaped by his time for his team as well, so splitting up top lane. Ace is gonna get some more farm, but maybe get to the point where he can actually have a big contribution in these fights, but as they do lose that last tier 2, gonna start losing their shrines. And losing more and more map control.
Radiant's top tower is under attack. Net worth, not as bad as we saw last game. Cloud9, they were down 20,000 net worth, only down about 6,000 now. Dikura trying to find a swap out on Ace, but here comes GG. He's got that illusory orb. Chikuchi out from Ace, and Noya gonna delta split down to the river.
Radiant's courage. G actually going for the Aghanims this game, so gonna force Weaver and Odie to sort of stay puts these two immobile cores. Well, Weaver not an immobile core, but cores that have no way to break this coil without getting the stun. So the extra stun duration, the extra damage, gonna put in a whole lot of impact. Also, can't buy a BKB to just totally negate all of Puck's usefulness. So it's gonna like just let this Laundry continue to wail away, like building all of this catch, all of this control, so that the Laundry can just do all this damage, especially with the Vengeance Aura on Angel Spirits, giving him even more damage, up to 333 a hit.
They will grab this second shrine, and Radiant's TP back, but maybe they think that C9 are in their jungle, and it wouldn't be wrong if they do make the rotation over there. Dira leading the charge with that Alpha Wolf thing. I haven't spotted anybody out just yet, but Baby Knight and Hestus Joe will show themselves on the creeps down low. There's the swap back, and stunned up is Noya with the weave coming through. And Dira grabs another one at 5-2. This opens up some space for the rest of Cloud9 to just kind of get out of harm's way.
Yeah. Sort of true to old Cloud9 form, just constantly pushing out these lanes, still pushing and just trying to buy time to a stage where they actually can fight this Weaver. Working on what looks like a Mjolnir, so gonna buy Mjolnir to help him farm a lot faster as the Maelstrom now, so gonna get these lanes out considerably quicker. And like we said earlier, they don't really have ways to deal with this Weaver once he has some items, so if he can get up to this 5-6 slotted stage, will be extremely strong and hard to deal with. Mjolnir helps him do that considerably, so I like to pick up a lot. Instead of going for something like the Deso versus all this armor they have, goes to the Mjolnir, works better versus their damage, and also helps them farm faster and scale better as the game goes later.
I'm gonna place that deep ward on the high ground over towards where a shrine once stood. They spot out Ryze, not gonna show himself as they know Roshi is up, and now they have the vision to go after this second agent. Oh, Ace possibly looking to come in. They know he's there with the sentry ward. That dominated creep. Cloud9 now know that Vega might be going for Roche. Smoked up on the side of Cloud9. Digera all by his own, so might be in a little bit of trouble. Blinking in his Baby Knight. There's the Astral Imprisonment. And around the side is Vega. They do have the Tombstone already dropped. Digera might be in a little bit of trouble. There's a vacuum over the wall. The Tombstone keeps him alive. There's the Thaddeus Eclipse. Still nobody dead on either side just yet. There is the Shallow Grave kept up on Digera. And it looks as though they've used the wall, they've used the Thaddeus Eclipse, and are yet to find anything on the side of Cloud9 on Vega.
Radiant's middle tower. Yeah, G only getting a one-man coil on the OD and just breaking it immediately. So he's not stuck in that vicinity, so Weaver free to run around and do as he pleases. The tomb got placed in a quite a good spot, but got killed immediately in the wall, only catching two. So like you said, what a big ult to use, but nobody falls. So Vega are gonna be happy with this, as they can just get these lands, move over to Roshan to finish it off.
And with all those big ults down, just head over towards Rosh. They've got the power to take it down pretty quickly. And with C9, like you said, throwing all those ults, it just doesn't seem like they'd want to come back in on a fight by the Rosh pit.
And the Laundry gonna take it. So having the Crystallis now as well, going for the Daedalus. Vega probably will be looking to end the game with this Aegis. Extremely strong right now. Their lanes are kind of pushing in though, so can't just run down mid right now. Or can they? None of Cloud9 are pushing out these lanes. Not really split pushing much right now, as Ace looks like he wants to make a move down to bottom to force them to come back, or maybe even wrap around on them. Yeah, it's gonna start split pushing, as Vega looks like they wanna take Rax or end the game right here right now.
Radiant's top Don't think Ace has enough to really force back the entire hand of Vega, especially with the Aegis. I feel like they'll be a little bit hesitant to come back. They know they can take a fight, and if they know Ace is down there, they know they've got the upper hand. Oh, Ryze is gonna go in with the Glimmer Cave. There's the Sentry Ward as the tower goes down mid. Nobody coming around the bend just yet. Ace is coming through. Seema might be in a little bit of trouble. There's the Alpha Wolf. Digera getting hit up a little bit, but nothing too crazy from either side just yet.
As they continue to chip away, Ryze gets the Sentry down and dewards. That ward's absolutely huge. Oh, Digera almost put the swap back in. It's not quite.
Actually gonna get disrupted. Ace on the back end, but Ace is immediately gonna get hit by a magic missile. He's under the sentry ward. There's a big five-man vacuum wall, but Ace isn't gonna survive it. They've brought down the Aegis of the Lone Druid already. Swap back into the fight is Baby Knight. He's gonna have to imprison himself. Digera getting very low despite having that BKB up. And now Baby Knight's gonna have to back off just a little bit. There's the three ward lower. Rooted up is Baby Knight. He's getting very low. He'll be the next to fall on Cloud9. They've lost three. And he's gonna immediately buy back to try and defend this Rax. And he's already lost the Raindrax. He's gonna TP in, trying to move forward. Maybe look for something big, as he does have that sanity equipped, so he's gonna have to steal a little bit of intelligence before he does do so. Mr. Joe, he's gonna be slowed up, and a little bit of trouble with that bear moving in on him. hard defense from Cloud9. Vega throwing everything they have at him.
Yeah, the Coil coming back up in 15 seconds as well, so if they do choose to stick around, we'll have that. But the Weaver coming back up, and the Odie has bought back. Need to risk giving them comeback gold. If any kills, I'm just going to back up, as they have lost the Aegis and Mag. Pretty close to finish off that Daedalus, so going to up his damage output quite a bit.
Especially with what happened last game where you were up 20,000 gold, I feel like you'd be a little bit hesitant to go in and go all in towards this middle Rax. Now without the Aegis.
I really like the itemization from Cloud9 supports, getting this Vlad's, getting a medallion, all this minus armor is. He chose to go for the Deso on Mag and not the typical Miona he go for on the range low druid, so building a whole bunch of armor items, going for the Shivas on OD. Almost there has the Mystic Staff, going for the Crimson Guard on Darkseer, like some unusual item decisions, but really trying their best to limit the long range long druid's damage output and stall for time, because once they get to a certain point, OD and Weaver are just gonna be too strong, combined with the Bloodlust, control this Demonic Purge, and he's just been disrupting the Venge every single fight with his Vengeance aura and sticking the illusions onto random support. So the SD having a big impact, it's always disrupting the Yuron, and continuing to try and stall for time. When they get these big armor items up, have the Shivas, Weaver gets a few more damage items. Win one team fight, this game can turn very, very quickly.
And we've seen it before, i.e. last game. Vega very knowledgeable on what it is to throw in recent history, and they don't want to have that happen again, especially when they have a chance to qualify for the next phase.
Ace may get caught here. They're all set up on the hill, may try for a swap into a stun. Pull him up, want to see. They don't have any vision of him right now though, so.
Nico's gonna lead the charge though. Not gonna spot him just yet. Here comes the boost travel in from G, so everybody's here on the side of Vega. Ace does get the opportunity to back off.
Oh, Noya very, very close to getting caught, just barely gets out of range. The extra movement speed for Bloodlust, and the strength boots keeps him alive there.
They keep placing the Sentry Ward for the side of Vega right down by these on the bottom end of the stairs, and that's perfect because Ace every single time has tried to come through behind them. Time it doesn't seem to go that way. Tombstone's gonna be dropped. He's taking a lot of damage from Mag. They're gonna force out that ult. He's gonna be feared up. They're still gonna grab this rack. There's the glitch coming in. G's got the Dream Coil out on him. There's the block coming in from Diggerod. He's gonna snap that Dream Coil. He's gonna get the disruption as well. But the four man vacuum wall gonna come in from head to Joe. The Sandy's Eclipse is dropped onto Vega. Still nobody dead. Diggerod with the BKB. He's gonna be the first one to fall in this fight. And now AC's gonna be looking for stragglers. Trying to go in on Simu, who's got that Shallow Grave. Sineko might be in a little bit of trouble. There is the Astral Imprisonment to keep him around. He will fall. Sineko goes down to Baby Knight, so they do hold again. About 9, they lose their racks, but kind of take that fight with no casualties.
Yeah, this Crimson Guard having a huge impact fight after fight after fight. It makes all their teams so tanky and hard to bring down.
Just lasting a really, really long time. Even these squishy heroes like the Shadowdeam with the Glimmer Cape kiting around. Nobody on Dire falling. As the Shivas and one creep now on Baby Knight as well, so it's gonna get harder and harder for Vega to take down these heroes, even though they do have this super nice combo of the Coil into the swap, so makes it very hard for Cloud9 to break bases. You can always just stun them for 4 seconds at your tier 3s, anytime they try, or at your tier 4s, anytime they try and push the level 3 swap. So, they definitely have some nice ways to pick people off, but getting tanky on Cloud9 and their heroes, if even or even close on farm, will scale better. So, it has to be very careful.
To me, it seems like maybe Vega missed their timing. They were up by so much, and they kind of seem to sit back a little bit, and it's starting to hurt them. Have they sat back too much, where we might see a repeat of Game 2, Cloud9 coming back?
I don't think they ever chose to sit and just not fight whenever they were strong. Just trying to get lanes out constantly, trying to find these heroes. I think it's more of Cloud9 just doing a good job of pushing out these lanes, always being all around the map. forcing them to rotate, to not be in the places they want to be. But Vega, speaking of making moves, are smoked up, running to top line, they know where they are. All inclined, now Cloud9 here, so may find a big team fight. Team has to continue to hit these big back walls, as that's been crucial. And
Yura's gonna try and lead the charge, he gets the disruption out on Yura. But now there's another three-man vacuum. The wall a little bit late. The tombstone is dropped. Yura gonna be helped by that shallow grave for the time being. They've got the dream coil out onto Baby Nightsoft again to be popped out of it. Nobody dead just yet. Hesta Joe getting very low. Ingrid is there, but they've already lost the lone druid. He's down for 25 seconds. Hesta Joe very low. They're gonna lose Yura. They've lost the third in Seema, and they've given up none on the side of Cloud9 as they finish off Seneko. So C9 again. They did it in game two, and they're doing it in game three. They have turned this game completely around, and it looks as though it is in their favor now.
Why does Lundgren have a 25-second respawn timer at level 21?
minus 50 seconds respawn time. It's that amazing talent.
So clowny.
Oh, baby,
yeah, it was a really.
Oh, sorry, you go.
Yeah, they're all just so tanky, like, as they're constantly dishing out these right clicks, but they get on top of this lone druid, and he has the DKB, but he's just getting right clicks by Weaver getting on top of him and just can't really deal with him. Once this Weaver is getting close to net worth, and now the Weaver only 2k trailing the lone druid, so not really the place you want to be as a lone druid behind the more mobile cores, like the Weaver that can just sort of get on top of you and trade hits better.
Don't know if Seneca wants to be in that spot right now, but they do get the Dream Coil out on two. There's the Tombstone. Noya gonna just try and TP out. He's gonna get figured out of that TP, and now they got the Waning Rift out on two, and they're gonna lose both Noya and Ace. Interesting play from C9 to stick around, and Vega, they make it worth their while grabbing both Noya and Ace.
Yeah, stuck around just a little bit too long, find a couple pickoffs, and with that, looks like they're gonna try and run down mid, maybe run up the top Rex, force a buyback out of the Weaver, be huge. That's a Daedalus and 200 gold on mag, so.
Unfortunately, Ace does not have the luxury of minus 50 second respawn time.
Yeah, unfortunately, really start being the most farmed hero in the game for quite a while. It's fallen quite far behind on net worth. Only 13k compared to 15 and 17 of the Weaver and OD. So, going for that Hurricane Pike next, but it's had this Yasha BKB HOD for quite a while. Slowly starting to stagnate, and Venge not here, they can have a super huge impact as a core unless she has a lot of items. Especially in a game like this, where there's so many physical mitigation items, like the Guardian Greaves now as well, and as a joke.
Cloud9, they've cut this lead. It used to be around 12,500, and now it's all the way down to 5. Vega are going to try and go for this Roche. No contest from Cloud9, and they will pick up the Aegis on Matt.
Has the Daedalus now just completed? Looks like Noya is going to be building up towards that AC slowly but surely as well. So just continuing to build up all these armor items, as much physical mitigation as possible from this Lone Druid. And Venge, they can survive long enough to slowly build up those int stacks. Get the Weaver to scatter around and get as many right clicks in as he can. As like we said earlier in the game, it's very, very hard for Vega to take down this Weaver unless he's heavily out of position. It's a little bit easier now that she has a hex, so another means to try and take some of these fights.
Ace looking towards level 23. We take a look over at Baby Knight. He's level 21. The talents he's picked up is the 15 intel, 5 armor, 250 mana. What do you think he's going to take on the level 25 talent? The spell amp or the increased?
I think most likely the duration. The spell amp isn't super useful. It could be good versus the 100, as he does have such little int, so it could do even more. And get to that point where you actually can one-shot him, but most of the time you take the 60-second Orb Steal, is it? Especially in these later game fights, it can last quite a long time. Whereas you hit the as you take a fight and then run to the base, can be really, really good for hitting the buildings as you actually do some physical damage with all that int built up.
Ooh, they're gonna get the Dream Coil on Hesta Joe, then swap him back. He's immediately gonna be melted by the side of Vega. They get the disruption out on one, so maybe Cloud9 able to fight as Dikura. And be able to get four staff out and retreat.
Man, Ryze always has the disruption on to the Venge. like every single fight, just constantly getting these the disruption on him and forcing the Venge back, just sticking him on him. So it's very, very hard for him to turn and fight. And he's just always got this these illusions just sitting there pummeling him. Do 150% of the hero's damage if both illusions are hitting. So Dira always having to just run around, not able to sit and lock onto a target.
Trying to deter Ace from really pushing up top. He does get the waning rift off, but meanwhile, Vega, they're just gonna try and destroy this tier 3 bottom, and they will do though. There's the disruption coming out. He still needs to drop by something and go. We might be looking to go all in here for the side of Vega with this Aegis. And Baby Knight tried to go in with that Divas, but he's gonna get hurt. Hitting Pike back. He's gonna get swapped in. Baby Knight's gonna go down immediately. There's a 4-man back in wall with the Guardian Grief getting popped on the side of Vega. The immediate buyback from Baby Knight coming in is Ryze. Just gonna try and slow down the side of Vega. Gets the disruption out again on Digura. And now moving in on the back end is C9. North 4-man, 3-man Dream Coil. With the little illusion there, everybody's gonna get stunned up. There's the illusion glove coming in. Baby Knight's gonna fall again. He's just fall back. They've lost two on the side of Clash. Vega's trying to finish it off this game. They're gonna hurt him, tie themselves forward. And now they've lost another in Ace. Hesed Joe gonna try and stir down. Noe is here. He's gonna get stunned up. Digura, he's gonna be with that Midas armor. Gonna get hit by the Ignite and the Fire Blast. And now there's the buyback from Ace. But Noe is gonna be the next one to fall. They finally
down illusion.
So no shell great for the side of Vega. They will finally pop that Aegis. They go in a little bit of trouble. He's doing a lot of damage. He's gonna get Ghost Scepter. He's gonna be able to drive for a little bit longer. Rooted up his Ace. He's gonna have to use that time lapse. And now they've got the Undying Dead as well. Digura on the bench, who doesn't have buyback for another 72 seconds. Magmite be in a little bit of trouble. He's up against Digura. Miss on the back end. Ryze falling. G is gonna try and get out. He's using that TP. Maybe they can find him. Ooh. That's the second too late on the disruption. But Mag, he's getting chased down by both Ace and Hester Joe. They're trying to chase him down with the Ion Shell. Ace gonna use that Shikuchi. He's gonna Hurricane Pike himself forward. There's the form thrown out. And
juke,
now,
juke, juke,
as though
run.
Mag is trying to juke out Ace, Ryze, and Hester Joe. But when he stops the TP, the juking stops and he will fall. And four end up going down on the side of Vega Squadron as we take a look at this team fight. Not going to give us everything. It's just going to give us the death by Mag. And with that, C9, it looked like for a split second it was over. Baby Knight, he went down, he bought back, and immediately fell again. But C9, semi-hold. Yes. Oh, voice back. Wow. I guess.
Yeah, they lose the range racks. They're forced to buy back on three heroes, both of their cores, as well as Ryze. They do manage to hold that wall, having a huge impact. It seemed like it did initially, but those illusions sort of marching forward and chunking down everybody. These wall illusions, the disruption illusions from the bench, just slowly whittling everyone down, killing all the supporting casts of Vega, and then saving Mag for last, who's almost has the Satanic now. But yeah, very, very good fight for Vega. Dying twice and buying back, so massively stunting Baby Knight's growth and items. Down to 14k where he was. Most of the other heroes.
Simba's gonna fall. Meanwhile, Ryze just getting the disruption on Mag. He's gonna get annoyed. He's gonna get the Demonic Purge as well as the Soul Catcher. Mag might be in a little bit of trouble. He finally gets swapped out by Digura. Very powerful. There's the Sanity's Eclipse with the vacuum wall. Digura, he's the second one to fall. C9, they look to be doing it. Zego's gonna try and get out, but he gets stunned as well as the Astral Imprisonment. They dropped the Stone down, but it's gonna be taken out by Cloud9. They will finally grab Sineko, and three are dead again as the Dream Coil does come out on three on the side of C9. But now it's just Mag, and it is just G on the side of Vega. They do a buyback on both the Venge, Digura, as well as Sineko on the Undying. So they're gonna look to get a couple of towers of their own on the side of Cloud9.
Radiant's middle tower. Yep, I forgot to mention this last fight, that super nice coil into the Savage Roar combo, popping the coil on all three of them. It's a really cool combo that you can do, and they did it perfectly, got out of three heroes and got them that range tracks and forced out a couple of the buybacks because of that super nice combo. So Nico has the buyback now, as like you said, they do sort of get chased down, caught out of position one by one, and lose some key heroes. It looks like they may lose their tier 3 or at least a lot of damage. Buyback down on Nico, so a little bit of a gold boost for Cloud9, and definitely how they want things to go from now on.
Yeah, they are really trying to bring it back to even. They had it so close at 5,000 net worth. Then it dropped. It went right back up to 15,000 after that fight bottom. But they brought it back down to 10 again, and Cloud9, never say never with them. They do not want to give up. They don't want to GG out. They want to win. They want to qualify for the next phase. And they are giving it their all in this game 3.
Yeah, with all these net worth swings, the the consistency of their predecessor may be lingering. Vega smoking up, running up this hill. It's a really good place for Cloud9 to meet. Still have, oh, a DD on Ace as well. It's not what you want to do.
Magma in a little bit of trouble. He's going to use that for game to get out. He's going to come in with the boost travel on the bear, but gets stunned up immediately. Snaker's going to have to use that ult. There's a Doom Coil out on Ace, and he's going to get so ripped. And now on the back end, they've got the wall down. Nobody did just yet. Dira's going to use that swap and use that with Terra out on Ace. Ace might be in a little bit of trouble. Ace is going to fall. He's down for 117 seconds, but G is dead as well. It's Dima Baby Knight just trying to fight. Bring down Mag. He's going to Astral imprison himself as he does not have Snatty's Eclipse for another 27 seconds. Trying to find his way out. Sineko's going to use that Ghost Sector coming over his ride. He's going to get the disruption out on Dira, but now Baby Knight's going to fall. Two cores dead by the Cloud Knight. They're still trying to move in. They brought down Dira. Sineko might be in a little bit of trouble. He's going to be hexed up and he's going to fall. Four dead on the side of Vega, but they do lose Baby Knight and Ace.
Yeah, that D hanging massive dividends. G had the refresher orb, wasn't able to get his second coil off, so he got then just obliterated by the Weaver with the DD. A three-shot wasn't able to pop the spaceship and live, but buying back up both the cores. They know they don't have buybacks in Weaver and OD. Vega are trying to end the game right now, as they know that the game is slowly slipping out of their grasp with some of these fights, and they want it to be over. There they go.
And they're gonna push down mid. G's gonna have two dream coils here with the refresher not on cooldown. And they're gonna look to finish it despite not having Seema or Seneca.
35 seconds on OD, they may be able to do this.
And there's Mag a lot of time on C9. Or with no BB9 and Ace. So they're gonna go after these tier 4s. It's gonna get flipped up immediately. There's the Dream Coil out on 2. Not popped on either side, but this Hesta Joe is gonna get very low. There's the Guardian Greaves. Hesta Joe in a whole bunch of trouble. He's gonna get the vacuum off, but it's not gonna stop anything. He does that buyback. And G coming in. G trying to get a kill out on to this Shadow Demon, and he will find a kill in Ryze. Now Noya is trying to run at Vega, trying to slow them up as they do get Baby Knight back in 2 seconds and Ace in 10. So they're just trying to extend their time. There's the second Dream Coil out on Noya, and now coming in is Baby Knight. Baby Knight's gonna use that Sanity's Eclipse and will bring down Dit-Yara. So they hold both tier 4. Seema might be in a little bit of trouble. Seema is right in the eyes of Baby Knight, and there's the Astral Imprisonment with the Poison Touch. There's the Lotus Orb coming out from Noya. Noya's gonna use that Fire Blast to hit onto Seema. Seema just extending his time. There is the Shallow Grave, just extending the inevitable. And Noya, Baby Knight, and Ace are all here, and they have helped their tier 4s.
Yeah, I think it may have been better for them to just try and hit the throne. So they chase around some heroes. They bought quite a bit of time, so it took them forever to kill all three of them. They took a lot longer than expected to kill Hest Joe, and now the Yara with no buyback, and Odie with a few instacks as well. So, gonna check Roshan. It's up in like 2 seconds. They just missed it.
Yeah, they're gonna miss this Rosh coming up, something they could, both teams could desperately use right now. And C9, they're gonna look to push as they've already got this top tower and set of racks. Look at that illusory orb speed.
Yeah, they got a rocket ship illusory orb, a rocket ship weaver, everybody's so fast.
Illusory Orb comes in, maybe trying to get to the back lines of Cloud9, and Shadow Demon as well as Hesta Joe are going to come in just a moment as they are a little bit far back on the other side of the river, and maybe Cloud9 back off and look to grab this shrine as well as Rosh, as they are going to spot it.
Yeah, the Lone Druid Bear is starting to become useless. It's just so easy to kill. The OD kills it 5 or 6 shots with all that pure damage. The Weaver Shred as well, his massive DPS. He has the Diffusal and now almost a Lincoln as well, so the Hex is going to be not near as useful. With the BKB and the Lincoln, the only real way they have to kill him is to coil and he moves it somehow. So with the Aegis on Baby Knight and almost this Lincoln's on Ace, Cloud9 are in a very good spot, even 1.5 racks down. Have the racks of their own, so technically only 1.5 racks down.
And there's no buyback. Position. No buyback on anybody on the side of Vega again, and that's how they kind of fell off last game. They had no buybacks, fought at the Rosh Pit, and then they lost that fight, and that was just it. So Cloud9 with the Aegis in hand might look to put the pressure on Vega and be the ones with the aggression.
Yep. And like, on top of all of this armor, all these armor items they're building, you get the Ice Ogre creep as well from the HOD, so armoring up everyone as well, just building up as much armor as they can. The lowest armor anyone has on Cloud9 is the Shadow Demon with 11 armor. Everyone else like around 30, so very, very hard for Vega to take down these heroes, as almost all of their damage is physical, and Dittyra has the Hurricane Pike, but hasn't really progressed past that in a long time.
Ace leading the charge for Cloud9 mid, and this could be the last stand for either side. I say that for mostly Vega, as Cloud9, they do have the buybacks available. Cloud9, they seem to be the ones who are putting on the aggression for what seems like the first time this game, as they've been defending for almost 50 minutes now. So they will get that tier 3, and now they might look towards Rax, try and bait Vega into a fight they don't want to take.
Yep, then they take down the tier 3, and he said, not many buybacks, only the, yeah, like you said, none on Vega, but Cloud9 doesn't know that, pushing in all these lanes. The Weaver still has saving for buyback, but finishing up that Lincoln's as well, so has enough gold for it. It'd be extremely hard to take down. And while trapped in their base, they're just gonna slowly out farms. Hestijo has the Hex, like we talked about before. One of those crucial fights, and has 4k gold on top of that as well, so maybe going for another Shiva's, maybe for a refresher, or maybe an Ags even, we'll have to see, but continue to scale up as Noya heading for a Hex as well. Aghanim's almost on rise, a lot of big items coming up, Octarine coming up, Baby Knight, so while it's Vega trapped in their base, not really building up to anything at all.
Yeah, Cloud9 continue to keep the pressure on. That top lane is just a trouble for Vega. And Cloud9 with the Aegis, they'll look and wait for their opportunity to go in and try and win this fight and win the game ultimately.
I really worry for this Ventral Spirit. She's constantly getting disrupted in these fights and just never really has the time to attack anyone. It's Odie and Weaver locking onto her, forcing her to BKB extremely early in these fights, never really having a huge impact because of all these armor items. Can't stress enough how much of an impact these item decisions are making in these fights.
Oh, Ace just leading the charge with his team right behind him. Vega just trying to keep them back and hope they can hold on to this Rax, but it's slowly getting chipped away. Bear will fall, and now Baby Knight flings it with it. She was gonna get the Hex down. There's that. He's supposed to keep your Ra already out of the fight. He's got no buyback. There's the Shell Grave used by Team. He's gonna try to keep himself alive for a little bit longer. There's the spaceship used by this Puck G, and Seneca looks as though he's gonna be the next one to go down, and he will, as C9 have taken two and lost none and pushed back the rest of Vega Squadron. That they'll be able to take this set of racks. They head towards bottom. They're looking for a tier 3 bottom as well as these mega creeps. They're looking to finish it off and win this series 2-1.
Yeah, like you said, no buybacks. No buyback into Euron, no buyback into Sneeko. Healing up, maybe looking for a last stand, but no coils on Puck. He has the Hex and his normal spells. Not really enough to force them off the base. The Aegis still up on Baby Knight.
There's the Hex coming through, and there's the Shell Grave used by Seema. Ryze is going to push them back even more. Gina with a bit of trouble. There's the Lotus Orb used by Ryze, and Baby Knight just continues to work on forward. Nobody really can stop Cloud9 at where they're at right now, and they've got themselves Mega Creep. They've taken down this tier 4, going in with a Waning Rift, and then, you know, Uzri Orb out. Ace is getting a little bit low, but he is still have quite a bit of health, despite being at half. Hex out, they're looking for more. Hestijo's gonna go in. There's recoil out on three. There's the Uzri Orb forward with the Waning Rift. They're trying to get the vacuum. They're trying to get something back. Trying to hit away at Hestijo. He's not gonna find anything. He's gonna get that Hurricane Pike back into the base. And they still only got three heroes alive. Two are dead on the side of Vega. They can't really defend it. Their agent's going down. They're looking to get this game on the side of Cloud9. They're trying to push it back on the side of Vega. Seema going in. Baby Knight might be in a little bit of trouble. He might fall. He's gonna lose that agent, but still Vega. They're in a whole bunch of trouble. They've lost Mag. They've lost G. Or they've just about lost G. He stays alive as Seema is the one who goes down, and then it's gonna be Dittyra fall. They'll take this ancient, and Cloud9 will come back again to win this series 2-1. Ooh. Quite a victory both times for Cloud9. They were down 1-0 in